Hi students, this is Professor Joe Angley. In this lesson, we will be learning about matter and the building blocks of life here on planet Earth. At the end of this lesson, you should be able to understand a few key points. These are, one, the law of conservation of matter, two, the concept of the atom, three, the pH scale, four, the four categories of biomolecules, and number five, the importance of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, and phosphorus in the chemistry of life. So let's get started. Everything that takes up space and has mass is matter. Matter exists in three distinct states, solid, liquid, and gas, due to differences in the arrangement of its constitutive particles. Water, for example, can exist as ice, a solid, as liquid water, or as water vapor, a gas. Matter also behaves according to the principle of conservation of matter, which states that under ordinary circumstances, matter is neither created nor destroyed, but rather is recycled over and over again. It can be transformed or recombined, but it doesn't disappear. Everything goes somewhere. Some of the molecules that make up your body probably contain atoms that were once part of the body of a dinosaur, and most certainly were part of many smaller prehistoric organisms, as chemical elements have been used and reused by living organisms. Matter consists of elements, such as phosphorus or nitrogen, which are substances that cannot be broken down into simpler forms by ordinary chemical reactions. Each of the 118 accepted elements, 92 natural plus 26 created under special conditions, has distinct chemical characteristics. Atoms are the smallest particles that exhibit the characteristics of an element. As difficult as it may be to imagine, when you look at a solid object, all matter is composed of tiny, moving particles separated by space and held together by energy. Atoms are composed of a nucleus made of positively charged protons and electrically neutral neutrons, circled constantly by negatively charged electrons. Electrons, which are tiny in comparison to the other particles, orbit the nucleus at the speed of light. Just four elements, oxygen, carbon, hydrogen, and nitrogen, symbolized as O, C, H, and N, make up more than 96% of the mass of most living organisms. This model represents a carbon 12 atom containing 6 protons and 6 neutrons in its nucleus, as well as 6 electrons orbiting its outer shells. Many scientists say electrons should be shown as a fuzzy cloud of wave energy rather than individual P particles. Each element is listed in the periodic table according to the number of protons per atom, called its atomic number. The number of neutrons in the atoms of an element can vary slightly. Thus, an atomic mass, which is the sum of the protons and neutrons in each nucleus, also can vary. We call forms of a single element that differ in atomic mass isotopes. For example, hydrogen, the lightest element, normally has only one proton and no neutrons in its nucleus. A small percentage of hydrogen ions, atoms, have one proton and one neutron. We call this isotope deuterium, or 2H. Atoms frequently gain or lose electrons, acquiring a negative or positive electrical charge. Charged atoms, or combination of atoms, are called ions. Negatively charged ions with one or more extra electrons are anions. Positively charged ions are cations. A sodium atom, for example, can give up an electron to become sodium ion Na+. Chlorine readily gains electrons, forming chlorine ions Cl-. Atoms often join to form compounds, or substances composed of different kinds of atoms. A pair or group of atoms that can exist as a single unit is known as a molecule. When ions with opposite charges form a compound, the electrical attraction holding them together is an ionic bond. Sometimes, atoms form bonds by sharing electrons. For example, two hydrogen atoms can bond by sharing a single electron. It orbits the two hydrogen nuclei equally and holds the atoms together. Such electron-sharing bonds are known as covalent bonds. Carbon can form covalent bonds simultaneously with four other atoms. So, carbon can create complex structures such as sugars and proteins. These common molecules with atoms held together by covalent bonds are important components of the atmosphere or are important pollutants. Substances that readily give up hydrogen ions in water are known as acids. Hydrochloric acid, for example, disassociates in water to form hydrogen ions and chloride ions. Substances that readily bond with hydrogen ions are called bases or alkaline substances. Sodium hydroxide, NaOH, for example, releases hydroxide ions, OH- that bond with hydrogen ions in water. We describe acids and bases in terms of pH, the negative logarithm of the concentration of hydrogen ions. Acids have a pH below 7. Bases have a pH greater than 7. A solution of exactly pH 7 is neutral. Because the pH scale is logarithmic, pH 6 represents 10 times more hydrogen ions in solution than pH 7. A solution can be neutralized by adding buffers or substances that accept or release hydrogen ions. The pH scale. The numbers represent the negative logarithm of the hydrogen ion concentration in water. Alkaline or basic solutions have a pH greater than 7. Acids or solutions where the pH is less than 7 have high concentrations of reactive hydrogen ions. Carbon is a particularly important element because chains and rings of carbon atoms form the skeletons of organic compounds, the material of which biomolecules and therefore living organisms are made. The chemistry of carbon is called organic chemistry. The four major categories of organic compounds in living things, bioorganic compounds, are lipids, carbohydrates, proteins, and nucleic acids. Lipids, including fats and oils, store energy for cells, and they provide the core of cell membranes and other structures. Many hormones are also lipids. Lipids do not readily dissolve in water, and their structure is a chain of carbon atoms with attached hydrogen atoms. This structure makes them part of the family of hydrocarbons. Carbohydrates, including sugars, starches, and cellulose, also store energy and provide structure to the cells. Like lipids, carbohydrates have a basic structure of carbon atoms, but hydroxyl groups, which are groups of O and H, replace half of the hydrogen atoms in their basic structure, and they usually consist of long chains of simple sugars. Glucose is an example of a very simple sugar. Proteins are composed of chains of subunits called amino acids. Folded into complex three-dimensional shapes, proteins provide structure to cells and are used for countless cell functions. Enzymes, such as those that release energy from lipids and carbohydrates, are proteins. Proteins also help identify disease-causing microbes, make muscles move, transport oxygen to cells, and regulate cell activity. Nucleotides are complex molecules made up of 5-carbon sugar, ribose or deoxyribose, one or more phosphate groups, and an organic nitrogen-containing base. Nucleotides are extremely important in signaling molecules, that is, they carry information between cells, tissues, and organs, and as sources of energy within cells. They also form long chains called ribonucleic acid, RNA, or deoxyribonucleic acid, DNA, that are essential for storing and expressing genetic information. The four major groups of biologically important organic molecules are based on repeating subunits of these carbon-based structures. Basic structures are shown for A, butyric acid, a building block of lipids, and a hydrocarbon, B, a simple carbohydrate, C, a protein, and D, a nucleotide, a component of nucleic acids. In this slide, we see a scanning electron image of DNA, which is an acronym for deoxyribonucleic acid. DNA is a nucleic acid which consists of a very long chain polymer of about 3 million base pairs of nucleotides arranged in a specific orientation to create the double helix. The functional unit of DNA is the gene. A gene is a sequence of nucleotides on the DNA which codes for the production of a particular product, normally a protein. In this way, DNA acts as the recipe or instruction set that tells a cell what protein to make and when. Certain regions of the DNA act to turn on a gene, and others act to suppress or turn off the gene. Here we see a close-up of a small section of four base pairs on a section of DNA. Note that the amino acids are arranged in a certain orientation where A is associated with T and C is associated with G. Also note the hydrogen bonds would give the DNA its double-stranded helical appearance. This picture is a composite molecular model of DNA. The lower part shows individual atoms, while the upper part has been simplified to show the strands of the double helix held together by hydrogen bonds, the small dots, between matching nucleotides A, T, G, and C. A complete DNA molecule contains millions of nucleotides and carries genetic information for many specific inheritable traits. All living organisms are composed of cells, minute compartments within which the processes of life are carried out. Every cell is surrounded by a thin but dynamic membrane of lipid and protein that receives information from the exterior world and regulates the flow of materials between the cell and its environment. Inside, cells are subdivided into many organelles and subcellular particles that provide the machinery for life. Some of these organelles store and release energy. Others manage and distribute information. Still others create the internal structure that gives the cell its shape and allows it to fulfill its role. Although scientists have identified 118 elements, only a few elements are especially common. Carbon is captured from air by green plants, and oxygen and hydrogen derived from air or water. The most important additional elements are nitrogen and phosphorus, which are essential parts of the complex proteins, lipids, sugars, and nucleic acids that keep you alive. Of course, your cells use many other elements, but these are the most abundant. You derive all these elements by consuming molecules produced by green plants. Plants, however, must extract these elements from their environment. Low levels of nitrogen and phosphorus often limit growth in ecosystems where they are scarce. Abundance of nitrogen and phosphorus can cause runaway growth. In fertilizers, these elements often occur in the form of nitrate, ammonium, and phosphate. Later in this chapter, we'll learn about how carbon, water, nitrogen, and phosphorus circulate in our environment. So based on what you've learned so far, do you know why fertilizer contains nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium? Why is nitrogen and phosphorus present in larger quantities?